Hello guys, and welcome to episode 2 of my Chelsea career. Just gonna like in this episode basically we're just gonna be playing the last preseason game, and then we're also gonna go into our first Premiership game, which is against Burnley. I think, you know, in the Premiership they go by the actual fixtures as well, which is quite it's really good, to be fair, because you know you want to go by the actual fixtures that they go on in real life. Champions League and Carling Cup and all that, they can't really predict the future at the end of the day, so those games won't be the same as they are in the, you know, in a real life, basically. But the Premiership fixtures should be the same. Here I am just changing the formation. For some reason, it went back to 4-2-3-1 for some reason. But like I said, I don't want to play that formation. I just want to play with the two wingers more central, so they get more of a more goals, basically. More of a threat going straight direct, basically. Hazard will get a lot more goals that way. Oscar Willian and Schürrle will get, maybe Salah, because, you know, if you watch a previous episode, he did bag us a few goals and, you know, put him in contention for the first game, which is against Burnley. We are also currently in the transfer market. I just want to basically just go into the transfer market and look for some English players, because the only thing that lets me down about Chelsea is the fact that we don't have enough English players in the squad. I know we do in the youth and in, you know, we've only got Gary Cahill, really. John Terry's, well, I say retired, but, you know, he sort of quit international duty because of the whole racism route. And there's also a few of the youngsters. You got Nathan Baker. Who's the other one as well? Izzy Brown. There's a few of the youngsters that basically just I want to probably push through as well. There you go. Beautiful shot there from Matic, but unluckily the goalkeeper saves it. Anyway, here's your boy. But unfortunately, he misses, and Fabregas gets an injury. Hopefully, it's not too serious, because, you know, he's been if you've watched this season, he's been phenomenal for us, picking up, I think it's 10, 11 assists already, which is just stupid. And I expect him to break the record, which is 20 by Thierry Henry. But as you see there, Hazard does what he does best, using his low centre of gravity. He gets to skip past players and then smacks it past the goalie to make that 1-0 to us. That's a great start for us. The only downside is, you know, Fabregas is injured. Hopefully, it's not too bad. Hopefully, it's just not too bad, because we need him. Although we have got strength in the squad, we've got Ramirez, we've got Mikel. Actually, I sold Mikel, didn't I? I sold him. I sold Mikel, so we're going to have to look for maybe another CDM. Trying to think who else there is. Like I said, I want to sign Ross Barkley if I can. I'm trying to think of any other English player in the back of my head that I can think of. Maybe the one from Everton. Is it Josh Stones? Something like that. I think he's a defender. But I don't think we need defender. That's the only issue with that one. Midfield, we could probably use, like I said, Barkley. Strikers, Diego Costa, Remy, and who else? Didier Drogba. But the thing is, Drogba said he's considering retiring at the end of the season. So maybe we should bring in an English striker, or maybe even use Brown as a striker, or even what's his name? I keep forgetting his names now. Nathan Aki, or not Nathan Aki. I forgot his name. Sorry about that, guys. But anyway, like I said, we're gonna have to look for another striker anyway when Drogba leaves. So we'll probably be scouting him for the season. I don't have to get a serious one like a Lewandowski or something like that, because at the end of the day, we've got Diego Costa and Remy, and they're perfectly two great strikers. So we just need someone who probably won't mind sitting on the bench as much, but, you know, we'll want a few games here and there. So we're going to have to look for a striker in that sense. My phone gets an email. Sorry about that, guys. But anyway, as you can see there, the FIFA predict that... They predict that Man City will come first in the Premiership, which isn't going to really happen. Come on, we know we're the best. Here I am, just looking for Ross Barkley. Like I said, I needed another. I just wanted some English talent in the team. The only thing I think that lets this Chelsea team down. You know when they released the England squad and it says all the clubs that they belong to, and the only one there for us is Gary Cahill. I just feel a bit disappointed by it. Like, there's Man United in there, there's Liverpool, Man City with Milner, etc. But I just want a few more English players in the team. That's all. So I'm going to be pushing them through. And like I said, the youngsters, I will be pushing them through as well. Transfer offer for Ramirez, rejecting that. Ramirez isn't going anywhere. He's one of the most... like, he can play anywhere. CDM, attacking mid, right wing, left wing. No matter what you tell him to do, he'll do it. That's the thing about Ramirez. Here I am just telling Matic just to sit back in that midfield and defend like he does in real life. Fabregas and Oscar, I'm going to give them the freedom to get forward, do what they do, assist, goals, pass. You know what they do. You've seen how they play week in, week out in the Premiership. So, like I said, that's what they're going to do. Like I said, Matic, I'm just going to leave him there to defend the back four, although the back four pretty much can defend themselves. The only issue I've got with my team is that Felipe Luis, because he's a great left back, but Azpilicueta is a great left back as well. So it's awkward because they're both really amazing players, and I just want to use them both. But Unfortunately, I can't at the moment. That's the only annoying thing. Ivanovic is not the quickest right back, but he does the job defending wise, so that's a positive in that sense. And then we're kicking off the game here against Burnley. I don't want the greatest of starts here. They get lucky with a nice little volley past Courtois there to make it 1-0 to them. In real life, we actually, in the first game of the season, we actually conceded first as well, like a nice little volley that went past Courtois as well, but we came back to win that game 3-1 anyway. And Williams barges through the defence, using his power and his determination just to get the goal, just drives through them and wins the ball and plays the pass keeper to bring that to 1-1. I love Willian as a player. I think he's underrated. People don't realise the work that he goes through up and down the field. And, you know, he's also a very skillful player. I think he's worked on his finishing and maybe a bit of his, you know, his decision making, he'd be a great player. But anyway, Hazard's going to pass the ball. I meant to have Acosta, but Willian's there anyway. He smacks it past the goalie to make that 2-1 to us. Willian's first game of the season gets 2 goals in the Premiership already. Who scored for us on the first day of the Premiership? Was it? It was Costa, Schürrle, and it ended up 3-1, didn't it? In the end, I can't think who else scored the third one. Was it Ivanovic? Yeah, Ivanovic with the header, weren't it? But anyway, they get the goal there, bringing it back to 2-2, which is very frustrating. Because I think it's Burnley. Like, what's going on? What's going on? Like, what the hell's going on here? But we end up all square at halftime and, like, just being 2-2. I mean, that's a very entertaining first half when you think about it. I mean, 4 goals in the first half, which is quite amazing. Shame it could have been, we should have maybe been leading, maybe a bit sloppy defending on my behalf. But Matic's going to give the overtop through ball to Willian, who's going to put the ball into the back of the net to make that his hat-trick. The thing about Willian, I can't see him getting a hat-trick in real life, but I can't see him doing it. But if it did happen, I don't think I'd be surprised, because like I said, I think he's got the quality. I guess I don't think his decision-making's that great and his finishing just needs to improve a little bit. But he's got a hell of a shot on him, like, he really has. Salah here is going to skip past players. Look at his pace that Salah has is ridiculous. He's going to place it past the keeper to, make, you know, say to me, pick me next game, boss, and I'll deliver. Because he, whenever I pick him, he scores. He reminds me a bit of Remy at the moment. You know, Remy, because I feel sorry for Remy, because Costa's in such great form, and Drogba's, you know, whenever he's playing brilliantly as well and scoring. And but the thing is, whenever Remy plays or comes on and scores, he scores as well. I mean, in the Champions League when we played Maribor, I think it was at Stamford Bridge, he came on. Oh, he started the game, scored, but then he had to go off injured, which is very disappointing for him, because I'm sure he wanted to prove to Mourinho that he could, you know, do it. Like, he could lead the line. I trust him. I think he's got, like, great technical ability, and the way he placed it past Lloris the other day was ridiculous. Lloris was planted, like, he couldn't even do anything. And the way he put Vertonghen on his arse, what? Anyway, that's going to bring this episode to a close. If you did like it, please give it a like. And if you are new around here, don't forget to hit that subscribe button. Like I said, we're scouting Ross Barkley at the moment as well. So hopefully, in the next episode, we should make a move for him. We should. Barcelona here coming in an offer for Salah. I'm not going to accept it. I think Salah's a great player. I'm going to use him as a squad rotation player whenever we play in the Capital One Cup, FA Cup, or just a few a few shitty games here and there. Look at Barkley's stats, dribbling, short passing, ball controls, all excellent. So we'll probably make an offer for him, like, you know, and then we'll see what Everton have to say. It's weirdly enough, because our next game is against Everton as well. They want 26 mil for him, which is, you know, it's not for an English player, because I personally think English players are always overrated. But anyway, we're going to submit that offer and we'll see what they say in the next episode anyway. Like I said, I hope you're having a wonderful day, by the way. Hope you enjoyed this, and I'll see you in the next episode. Peace!